We often say how we should strive for quality over quantity. Many of us don't realize how in order to go for quality, you need critical thinking. And in order to have critical thinking, you need quantity. Many say people are being too critical nowadays. That wasn't the case a few decades ago. Look how everyone is constantly shitting on the new Star Wars or the new Dragon Ball. Nobody was doing that when the first ones came out. Oh, really? Could it be because there were far fewer titles in the past? The big three were constantly rivaling each other. What was rivaling the original Dragon Ball or the original Star Wars? Nothing! To anyone who thinks I'm being too critical because I got old and I'm blinded by nostalgia. To anyone who thinks everything I watched as a kid is amazing while everything coming out now is crap because I view them with an adult mindset. Let me remind him how little there was in terms of entertainment when I was a kid. I vividly remember the year when anime began airing in my country's television. It was 1988. There were three of them. There were only three others besides me watching them in my village. We all liked them. We had no reason to be critical. Why would we? There were only three of them and we all agreed they were fine. Fast forward to the early 00s. It was the beginning of the big three wars and I had access to the internet for the first time. All of a sudden there were thousands of anime and thousands of people talking about them. I became critical. Why not? Everyone was constantly recommending you stuff to watch or was debating which show did something better. Of course, and I had to begin defining quality through quantity. I had to explain why I prefer this shit from the other thousand shit. So to anyone who says we are being too critical nowadays, I reply, we are not being critical enough. There are 50 anime airing every season. If I include the cartoons and the live-action series and the movies and the video games, we are talking about several hundreds of new titles coming out every season. By default, you have to be 100 times more critical than I was as a kid, so you can decide what you are supposed to watch from all this mess. But you don't see the majority of the viewers pointing out which ones are definitely the best, do you now? Yuri on Ice, best anime of 2016, and thousands get offended when someone says it's not! There were only three anime back in my childhood. What's the point of being critical when there were only three of them? Nostalgia clouding judgment, my butt! Why bother to point out the plot holes in the first Star Wars and the first Dragon Ball when there was nothing remotely similar airing to make a comparison? Now is the time for people to be more critical than ever before. Now, when they are getting hundreds of new stuff every season, many of which are similar to each other. But instead of that, you get millions circle-jerking around the worst in quality shows, making you lose faith in humanity with how almost nobody's using critical thinking and yet complain about people being too critical. But I understand why many say that. It's because the majority doesn't care about quality or critical thinking, even though their generation demands it 100 times more than mine, thus not being on board with the times. And I get it. You consume trash because you seek comfort. I was doing the same thing. The difference is, I wasn't eating enough trash to realize they were trash. My excuse is, there were no better alternatives when I was a kid. What's yours? Why are you ridiculing yourselves on a daily basis? Why do you form huge groups of equally cringy people and you don't stop self-loathing yourselves instead of being critical? I could never do that as a kid and I was a chuny for 5 years. There were only three other anime fans in the village, so I had to make sure never to let loose in front of anyone else. I mean, can you imagine what would happen if we were deliberately acting like man children in public? The rest of the village would be making fun of us non-stop and we wouldn't have a group of 1,000 other man children so we can hide inside and keep acting the same way because we think it's normal. That way we wouldn't have to listen to criticism. Even at a time when I didn't have to be critical, I was more reasonable than the average kid nowadays who is constantly being sheltered no matter what he does. Think of the children, don't be mean to them, they just express themselves. That's strange. Bullying was normal when I was a teenager. Everyone was doing it. I was doing it. Nobody killed himself and we came out manlier than ever. We were fighting back. We learned how to be critical and use legit counter-arguments. Do you know why? Because we were not sheltered all our lives. In conclusion, quantity beckons quality. The more you have of something, the more critical you should be about it. Not the other way around. People of today are not nearly as critical as they should be, as they are self-absorbed in their chuny shit, ready to snap and call their buddies to harass anyone who tries to tell them otherwise. And this comes from me, someone from a time when we didn't have to be critical. Oh, the irony! And this is yet another reason of why retro always wins.